Today I want to teach you how to solve tasks from physics in which we have to find the place where a thrown object will hit the obstacle. This obstacle usually is some hill. You can see it here. That's the hill. Or horizontal platform. You can see it here. Is platform or vertical wall. It's here. The idea of this method is simple. We will try to write equation of the path of the thrown body in x-y coordinate system and write equation of the line describing the obstacle. Next, we will find coordinates x and y for the point that belongs to both lines. To find equation of the path of thrown body, we can use equation of motion. It is here. In this equation, x0 is coordinate of initial position. u0 is initial velocity. Exactly speaking, it is coordinate of this vector. Coordinate of a vector is equal the value of vector, if a vector is directed the same as axis, or minus value of vector, if it is opposite to the axis. A in this equation is coordinate of acceleration vector, so it can be positive or negative. We can write equations of motion independently for direction of axis x and y. To do it, we have to replace velocity vector v0 by components of this vector in the direction of axis x and y. Here there is v0 y and here is v0 x, components of the vector v0. These components are directed the same as axis x and y, so their coordinates are positive. Acceleration vector is directed vertically to the ground, so its coordinate in the direction of axis y is negative. You can see it here. Value of coordinate of acceleration vector equals minus g, where g is gravitational field strength. It has the same value as the acceleration due to gravity near the surface of Earth. We choose x and y for initial position of thrown body equal to zero. We have to express v0 x and v0 y by v0 and sine and cosine of alpha. It's done here. Now we can write equation of motion for the x-axis and y-axis. For x-axis, x0 and a are equal 0, and u0 is equal plus v0x. So, the equation of motion in the direction of axis x looks like this. X equals v0x times t. For y-axis, y0 is 0, u0 is equal plus v0y, and a is equal minus g. And here we have equation of motion for the axis y. So, we have two equations of motion, and we get rid of t from these equations. It's done here. Next, we replace v0x by v0 times cosine of alpha and v0y by v0 times sine of alpha. It's done here and here. Instead of sine of alpha divided by cosine of alpha, we can write tangent of alpha. It's here. Instead of this, now we have equation of path of the thrown body. It's here. Now, it is enough to write equation describing the obstacle and combine these two equations to find the coordinates of the point that is part of these two lines. If the obstacle is a hill, its equation is just equation of straight line y equals ax plus b, where a is tangent beta and b is zero. So, equation of the hill is y equals tangent beta times x. You have it here too. So, we have equation of the path of the thrown object here and equation of the obstacle of this hill. It's here. And we put right side of the second equation to the left side of the first equation. It's done here. Next, we take all these expressions to left side and change form to this. Left side is equal to zero if x equals to zero. This is the place from which we throw our body. The second solution was what we were looking for. If we put this value to first or to the second equation, we can calculate value of y. If the obstacle is a platform parallel to the ground, then its equation is just y equals h. You have it here and here. Now, it's enough to put right side of the second equation to the left side of the first equation. We've done it here. And take all these expressions to the left side. As you can see, we have quadratic equation and we can calculate roots of this equation. If the obstacle is a vertical wall, its equation is just x equals L. Have it here and here. We put this value to right side of the first equation and calculate value of y. So, we have solved our problem, and it is the end of this lesson.